Hello, EFMP families. It's great to be with you again, sharing some time to keep you informed on significant exceptional family member program transformation initiatives and the build of the EFMP Central Cell. Today, instead of showing the EFMP Central Cell organizational chart, I want to take some time to introduce the amazing cell staff working to advocate for EFMP families. Ms. Tammy Nelson, the EFMP Transformation Leader, is at the center of all things EFMP, leading the charge to make things better for our airmen, guardians, and their families. I'm Tammy Hearn, and I serve as the Director of the EFMP Central Cell with two branch chiefs, Dr. Arlene George, the Medical Operations Branch, and Ms. Kim Schuler, the Assignment and Family Support Branch Chief. We have a team of subject matter experts steeped in program policy and procedures. Lieutenant Colonel Laura Haver, the medical subject matter expert, Ms. Shanique Floyd, our assignments expert, and finally, Ms. Sandra Nichols, the Family Support Program Manager. Today, we also have the opportunity to introduce you to our newest team members, Ms. Sharon Acca, the EFMP attorney, and Ms. Marcine Woodley, the special education specialist. We have just a few more teammates to bring onto the team, 5 registered nurses, the TRICARE liaison, and our respite care coordinator. We'll keep you updated. Ms. Nelson is on deck with the program transformation update.
Thank you, Ms. Hearn. As you can see, Ms. Hearn has been busy getting her team built up, and I'm anxious for you to meet the rest of the team a little bit later in our video today. I wanted to give you just a few quick updates on where we are in the transformation. First, we've told you about the National Defense Authorization Act requiring that we standardize respite care and our EFMP processes. We're still working on it. We're making some good progress, though. You've got some great representatives for the Air Force on that team representing the Air Force. Respite care is the biggest one because we told you we had a policy coming, and then we kind of got stopped with the standardization. We're going to do this in 2 phases. We need to get you the policy. So that's coming hopefully here in the next 6 to 8 weeks. Well, you will see our policy. Following that will probably be some more changes. We're going to put it in as fast as we can and as clearly as we can. So there will be a lot of training coming along with our changes. One of the things I've recognized over the past couple weeks talking with families is I'm not sure I've done a good job explaining the differences in our new process. So I wanted to give you just a few things that are different. We talk about online forms. That's as compared to you having to do everything on paper today and either scan it in or hand deliver it, and then we call you and say the signatures aren't in the right place and all those things. Our new online forms will be a questionnaire that you can truly do online or with an app on your phone, and it doesn't let you submit until it's been signed in the proper places, and it lets you sign digitally. So I just wanted to give you a little bit of a comparison of what's different. A second thing is doctor appointments. Today, we make you go to all the doctor appointments, have them sign off on the paperwork. We know that's stressful. We know that's stressful for families, especially during a time when you already have all the stress of a PCS move. So we're going to change that in our new process. In new process, you won't do any of those doctor appointments unless we call and ask. There may be a few times when our medical cell will reach out and say, you know, we really need you to go get this updated with your doctor. But that's the very small percentage of time. Most of the time, we will work off your medical records. So you'll sign a release for your medical records, and then our folks will go to work collecting those records, and they'll review and call you with any questions. So that should take a lot of stress off your family at a time when you're trying to PCS, no more doctor appointments. So that's another great big change. The other thing that's coming that you don't have today is being able to track your case. So you will be able to log back in and see at what stage is your case in the process. So if it hasn't moved, obviously you're going to be able to reach out and say, hey, why hasn't this moved? My losing base SNC hasn't forwarded it. Or I see it's at the medical cell and it's been there for 2 weeks. Do you need other information? What's the story? So we're going to provide you that tool to be able to hold our teams accountable. So those are just a few of the changes coming. I wanted to make sure that I've described it adequately. I don't think I've spent enough time in the past giving you a, here's what's different. We'll continue to bring these forward to you. I'll bring you two or three probably each time we talk. Last time we talked, we asked for volunteers to test our new system. So we had 38 of you stand up and say, I want to volunteer, thank you. So we have 38 folks testing the system. We did have a little glitch, so we were delayed a few weeks. But the good news is, the more of this we find before we go live, the better it's going to be. And in this case, we're going to get it fixed. It is fixed. We're coming back forward to say, okay, now we're ready to test. So stay tuned. We're still making great progress with our system, and I still expect us to be up and running here later this summer. So quick update for me, but I just want you to know everything is still moving forward. Thank you for your time today.
Thank you, Ms. Nelson. We'll now hear from Dr. Arlene George, our medical branch chief of the EFMP Central Cell. Dr. George?
Thank you for that introduction, Ms. Hearn. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Dr. Arlene George. I'm the chief of the medical branch for the EAP division, and I'm excited about being here. We have a group of doctors lined up to serve the needs of our families. We have a pediatric gastroenterologist. We have pediatricians. We have psychiatrists. We have internal medicine. We have aerospace medicine, occupational medicine, generalists, lined up to serve and evaluate your family's needs, making sure that where you're going is safe for you and safe for your family members. We also have a team of 4As. They're really your communication hub. They make sure that that your family's needs are identified. They make sure that they're there to serve and help with the communication, the flow of communication. Because in any partnership, in any relationship, communication is the key. We're excited about the EFMP program. We're excited about being impact players for the EFMP program. But more importantly, we're excited about serving you and becoming the gold standard for EFMP across all services. Thank you for allowing us to serve you.
Thank you, Dr. George. Please welcome Ms. Sharon Acca, our new EFMP attorney in the centralized cell. Ms. Acca?
Hello, everyone. My name is Sharon Acca. I'm the EFMP attorney at the EFMP Central Cell. My role here is to serve you through expertise in special education law, training for local legal assistance attorneys, outreach to families and to EFMP staff across the Air Force, as well as policy guidance. I am very, 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 very excited to be able to be a resource for you, and I look forward to working with you.
Thank you, Ms. Acca. I'm pleased to announce our new EFMP Special Education Specialist, Ms. Marcine Woodley.
Hello, everyone. My name is Marcine Woodley. I am the Special Education Specialist for the EFMP Central Cell. I am a teacher, a special education teacher with more than 20 plus years of service. I've taught all grades, pre-K through 12th grade. My vision here for my role in the EFMP cell is to assist families with becoming advocates for their child in education. Thank you so much. I look forward to working with you.
Thank you, Ms. Woodley. Our next guest needs no introduction. You all have seen her around the EFMP program for several years. The chief of our Assignments and Family Support Branch, Ms. Kimberly Schuler.
Hello, everyone. I'm Kimberly Schuler, Chief of EFMP Central Cell Assignments and Family Support Branch. It bears repeating each time that we talk about the multitude of resources available to EFMP families, whether it's family support coordinators within the Airman and Family Readiness Centers, the EFMP Medical Office within the Military Treatment Facilities, military personnel flights, school liaison offices, installation legal offices, and so many more, that there are multiple ways for you to contact us. Of course, our hope is that your local agencies are able to assist you first. But in times when something goes awry and you need to contact us at the EFMP Central Cell for additional assistance, we want to make sure that you have all of our contact information. Facebook.com/Air Force EFMP is a phenomenal resource that our families love to use to message us and have communication directly with the team. The Department of the Air Force Family Vector website can be accessed at daffamilyvector.us.af.mil. This website has valuable resources and information, including contact information for all your local resources and helping agencies. The Total Force Service Center is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, at 1-800-525-0102. Press option 7 for families. Also listed on the DAF Family Vector website is our organizational workflow that you see on the screen. Remember, we are here to serve you and look forward to working together.
Thank you, Ms. Schuler. Great information, and we look forward to hearing from our families. This next introduction is bittersweet for everyone involved with EFMP. Lieutenant Colonel Jen Cowie is a relentless advocate for our EFMP families and an amazing teammate. Although we are sad to see her go, we wish her the best in her next adventure. It's my honor to introduce one last time, Lieutenant Colonel Jen Cowie.
Hello, everyone. I'm Lieutenant Colonel Jen Cowie from Headquarters Air Force Services, coming to you today to say thank you for letting me participate in all the EFMP improvements over the past year and a half. My time here at A1S has come to an end, and I'm so very thankful and blessed to have been a part of this journey with each and every one of you. I wish you all continued success, and I will continue to champion EFMP in just a different capacity. It is my pleasure and honor to introduce Ms. Sharon Thompson from Headquarters Air Force Services as my replacement.
Thank you, Lieutenant Colonel Cowie. As Lieutenant Colonel Cowie said, I'm Sharon Thompson, and I have more than 30 years of experience working with family programs. Most recently as the Airman and Family Readiness Center Flight Chief at Little Rock Air Force Base. I'm very excited to be part of this team, helping to shape the future and the positive changes we're making to support our airmen, guardians, and families. I encourage you to provide your input, your thoughts, your ideas, your recommendations. Your feedback is the key to the success of this program. So please reach out, we want to hear from you. Thank you again for this warm welcome, and I look forward to connecting with you.
Thank you, Ms. Thompson and Lieutenant Colonel Cowie. So as you can see, the EFMP Central Cell team is coming together. This team is full of energy and excited to continue to improve the services we provide our EFMP families. Thank you again for joining us today. I encourage you to connect with the team and share your experiences.